spiritually awake probably like 2009. By 2012, I relocated to Mexico, southern part of Mexico to be exact, during the whole Maya prophecy event. And of course, nothing happened. But by that point, I was already looking into other things, and I had my own understanding about the Great Awakening. That's when I think everybody really was starting to search, research. Just, they knew, people knew stuff was wrong. I'm not going to get into the politics or anything like that right now. It does play a role, but there's no point to really get into that. And so what happened was, is after 2012, and I became just engulfed in researching, trying to figure out what was going on. And I was trying to connect the dots. And the thing what was funny about that was, is something was missing. By 2014, I was already making videos about the Hollow Earth. Wow, I mean, because of the Hollow Earth, I was looking into Admiral Byrd and Nazi Base 211. 2015, that took me down the rabbit hole of Flat Earth. It just all made sense in my mind from the get-go, because I became spiritually awakened before I became worldly awakened. And I had this question. I kept, every time I would listen to a debate or listen to a prominent Flat Earther, I never would hear them bring this point up, and it always bewildered me how they couldn't see it. This is the one aspect, and it's from a biblical perspective. So I don't expect a lot of people out there to understand where I'm coming from, but it's very significant in the whole scheme of everything. And here's the point. The point is, how does Satan prolong his authority here on this earth? How does he prolong it? And it's quite simple. It's very quite simple. According to the Gospels, Jesus cannot even return in the end days till every nation and every people has had a chance to accept him. Summons it up completely. The irony in all this is that means there must be more indigenous people. Then you got Antarctica, a continent that you can't even go to. And when you do, you're going on their tour. You're not going out any farther than they want you to. You're going to be killed. Your boat will be sunk. Obviously, that's happened here recently. And in my belief, there's more land and there's more indigenous people. They're hiding in indigenous people, not the resources. Well, if you want to look at it that way, it is a resource for Satan. Because if there's more indigenous people, we can't evangelize them. Guess what happens then? Satan's time is prolonged. It's ironic that there's an Antarctica treaty, and this is the thing that blew my mind. It's as basic as just opening up your Bible and reading that profound verse. Jesus cannot even return until every nation and every people has had a chance to accept him. Either there's more land beyond the Antarctic wall, or there's more land in the South Pacific. Either way, Satan's time here is extended. And now we get to the spear. Oh, Satan loves the spear. He loves it so much. Because on a spear, you can't have a bottomless pit. The point of it is, Aleister Crowley himself wrote in the Equinox, a scientific journal, that it was the agenda of the governments of the world, the scientific community as a whole, hear that, as a whole, to change the demonic into the cosmic. Very profound statement to make. There can't be a bottomless pit on a spear. On a flat earth, oh yes, you can have a bottomless pit. episode below. As heaven is above, hell